Je pense que j'ai vraiment amené tout mon style, toutes mes influences dans ma prod, très naturellement. Et mes influences viennent de toutes sortes de choses. Puis, but one major one was like animation, cartoons. Yeah. So it was very natural for me to start putting faces on things. Yeah. But in a very subtle way as well. Tu sais, les cartoons que j'aimais, c'était des séries japonais et de Chine aussi. Puis ils ont un look très clean, très simple, and not too extroverted. But I think when you put a face on something, it just becomes extroverted. So I think it depends on the type of face. Yeah. J'aime the versatility que la céramique offre. En plus, la processus, tu sais, j'aimais, like, I liked throwing on the wheel, j'aimais ça, le façonnage aussi, tu sais, toucher à l'argile. Like, I liked the whole kit, and I liked how it seemed so vast, and, like, the limits were limitless, pretty much, and that's really awesome, you know? And it's through also mistakes and through repetition that you start discovering like different shapes, different objects, other things that you could do. So without that repetition, without that production side, I don't think it's possible, at least for me, maybe it's not for other people, but I don't think it's possible to push certain objects further, you know, and to make new things. Quand je prends la tasse et je fais la face, tu sais, like, I make sure that it doesn't become automatic, you know? So each object has a certain amount of love given to it and a certain amount of personality, because even though it's kind of like the same face, they're all kind of different because it depends how tired I am, how my arm's feeling, I don't know. And at the same time, for me, it's like a choral, a symphony, of this particular universe that I'm trying to create. So it's not only one piece, it's part of like an orchestra. Yeah, absolutely. And yeah.